our grandparents gave it good friends. Amen. We also don't want to honor this pastor without recognizing his wife, Lady Hicks. Amen. I thank the Lord for these preachers that thought enough of me to call me. Okay, how bad they talk about me behind my back. Reverend Stewart, Reverend Robinson, and Reverend Ford. Amen. Clap your hands for that. Theme scripture is coming from Luke chapter 4.
All right.
Beginning at verse 18. Luke chapter 4, beginning at verse 18. And it reads, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he had anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He had sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captive, and recovering of sight to the blind, to set at liberty them that are bruised, to preach the acceptable year of the Lord. And if you allow me, let's go on down to verse 20. And he closed the book. And had gave it again to the minister and sat down. And the eyes of all them that were in the synagogue were fastened on him. Lord, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be pleasing in thy sight. O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
In this book that we call our Holy Bible, Jesus is reading this book.
Well,
he's reading this book in the synagogue because it was the Jews' custom on the Sabbath. You know, they would have somebody to read, somebody to expound, and that would be their worship.
Yeah, right.
One of the first things that we see here is Jesus was attending worship. Why would the King of Kings, why would the Lord of Lords have to attend worship for something that was going on for what he already had on the inside? The spirit of his Father. Jesus just came from the mountaintop after being tempted by Satan. And as preachers, let me just talk from a preacher's point of view. You can be tempted. Even when you're trying to do good. Even Jesus was tempted. And at the beginning of chapter 4, you already see that he was full of the Holy Ghost. So he already had some defense mechanism inside. But yet still he was tempted. I don't know if any other young preachers are like me, but I've been tempted. Tempted to go off. Tempted to go left. Tempted to backslide. Church. And not only would he go by the church, but he'd open the book. And he'd read a little bit.
Yes, sir.
It fascinated me that the word would read the word. And then he would rest on the word. The word would read the word. And then rest on the word. What are you talking about, Donnie? The Bible says in John, in the beginning was the word. And the word was with God. In Isaiah, I think it's the 61st chapter, where he says, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he had anointed me. To be anointed is simply to be privileged or allowed. We have a lot of people who may be preaching but have not been granted that privilege. A lot of people driving who are driving but have not been granted that privilege. There are a lot of people participating in church that are participating but have not been granted that privilege. But to be anointed means to be privileged. So he says, he has anointed me to preach the gospel. What is the gospel? The good news. Come on. To the poor. I'm trying to stay within that time frame. I told them they gave me a preacher's text, not a teacher's text. He sent me to heal the brokenhearted. We can't be so heavenly minded that we're no earthly good. We can't be so caught up in our collars and our hollers the way we forget to touch those who are hurting.
Come on here.
To the deliverance to the captives and recovering sight to the blind. Recovering sight to the blind lets me know that they weren't always blind.
Well,
and here we're talking about the backslider. Yeah. He said in his prayer that he's married to the backslider. Don't look down on me because I slipped up one time. Don't look down on me because I missed two Sundays of church. Become a drug addict. Love on them anyway. Somebody loved you with your nasty, filthy self. Stop acting like you always had it together. Your clothes weren't always lying before you came to church. You always have all the money that you needed. You had to borrow money from the church too. But because we're preachers now, because we're missionaries, because we have a certain seat in the church, because our name has been given on a plaque, now we've forgotten where we've come from. But Jesus said, I know better than anybody else. But he simply sent me. You know, most of the time when Jesus was doing his preaching, he wasn't inside the church. This is just one of those few occurrences that we see. But see, he was among sinners. Preaching and teaching sinners, then making disciples. In verse 19 it says to preach the acceptable year of the Lord. I say, what does that mean right there, Jesus? The acceptable year is simply the favorable year.
All right.
So as a preacher, I can stand here and proclaim, I can prophesy that things that are going on right now won't always be going on, because I can prophesy and say, hey, this is about to be the year of the Lord. The Lord is about to do something. And I just dare you, during this revival, just say to these preachers, the Lord is going to do something. The Lord is going to do something because y'all have been praying. Oh, y'all ain't really trying to believe that. Atmosphere. I didn't know what I was walking into. I said, Lord, is this the great technology? Is this the time to come by the Central District? The Reverend Grant's teaching us. I said, Lord, I used to fall asleep, but I feel the fire. The favorable year of the Lord. Have the last word, and oftentimes it got me beat up. But my mother, she would say something, and I would say, why? Because I said so, and at the end of that, she'd say, case closed.
Right.
My daddy would say, point blank, period. Jesus had no reason to go on. He had no reason to even preach after he had read that scripture, because he said that the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. Yeah. He is the Lord, I'm God. So he had no reason to go on. He simply said, hey, I am. I am the one who was prophesied that would be coming. I am the way, the truth, and the life.
Yes, sir.
This Jesus closed the book. Guess what else he did? He sat out.
Yeah.
preachers.
Yeah.
And they gave me a nickname, Bishop, and I was like, okay, that sounds good. But then when the Lord really did call me, I was like, I don't want to do that. Am I the only one preachers?
No.
Okay, I didn't. But because he has sent me, do what the Lord say do.
Amen.
Do what the Lord say do. And I'm not just talking to preachers. Because as you mentioned, sisters, you got a mission.
Yeah.
Pray.
Yeah.
See the face of the Lord. The Bible says, if my people, which are called by my name, we need some stuff right now.
Yeah. Yeah.
But if they would humble themselves and pray, see my face,
yeah,
turn from their wicked ways,
yeah,
I'll hear from heaven and I'll hear their later.
Yeah.
Anybody in here need healing in your land? No, I'm not talking about the White House. I'm talking about the church.
Yeah,
you get your house in order. The Lord keep the White House. So I can't hoop and holler. I'm just a thing speaker tonight.